Hello students, and welcome back to the next session of our subject social science. So as you know, we have started chapter 6, impacts of the British rule in India. In this chapter already I have shared two videos with you in which we have learned many things. We have learned the condition of India before the British arrived, and afterwards when the British arrived what happened. We got the information about the agriculture, how the farmers were suffering because of the policies which Britishers were bringing. Also, we came to know how the trade and the industries, they were lost. They have lost their that much, you know, grandeur, they have lost in India. So, today we are going to proceed with the next topic, suspicion about the reforms. The reforms which the Britishers were bringing, the changes which the British were doing in our country, India. Here, the people of India, they were having some suspicion. Means they were having some doubts on the Britishers that what actually they want to do. As I've told you, that time the people were having the fear that we might lose our Indian culture forever. So what happened? Let's see. Do you think the Britishers were here just only to take our money, or they want to do some good also in our country? They want to seriously change our society. What is the answer? So let's find out. First thing, when Lord William Bentinck came to our country, he was a person who was seriously thinking about bringing that reforms around us, inside us, that are going to help us. Actually, they wanted to, you know, help us in progressing. What he did, Lord William Bentinck became quite popular in India by introducing few beneficial reforms. Whatever reforms Lord Bentinck has taken out, actually it was very beneficial for our country. During this time, Indians started getting jobs in company administration. First thing is, they were changing the policies. This policy was there now onwards that the Indians also can get the job in the company administration. Means earlier, which posts were only allotted for the Britishers, now slowly they were given to the Indian people also. William Bentinck passed a law in 1829 to ban the practice of sati along with Raja Ramnath Roy and other social reforms. When the Britishers came, they have seen that scenario of our country in which we were blindly following some social events like sati pratha, doodh piti, etc., etc. There were so many social events which were happening, which were prevailing in our society at that time. So the Britishers actually wanted to help us to reduce it. They wanted to change the society. So what Lord William Bentinck did? Lord William Bentinck, they passed a law in which the sati pratha, the practice of sati, was banned. This law was passed in the year 1829, and in this thing, our own people like Raja Ramamohan Roy and the other social reformers of that time, our Indian social reformers, they were also helping Lord William Bentinck. So the orthodox class people, whose thinking was not that much progress in the Purani thinking, they thought that the Britishers are going to destroy our culture. They were having doubt on the intentions of Britishers. But it was not so. Britishers wanted to help the Indian people. Company passed a resolution to spend 1 lakh rupees every year on education, but it was not implemented. When Lord William Bentinck was here, the company registered their company to pass a resolution that from now onwards, every year 1 lakh rupees will be given by the company to increase the English education. Yeah, to increase the English education in our country. But it was not implemented. Wo kabhi aaya hi nahi, implement hua hi nahi. Finally, an education committee was formed during the time of Bentinck. Finally, when Lord William Bentinck himself, he thought about it and he looked over that matter. He got a committee organized on that. A committee banai gayi thi which can look after to increase the English education to help the Indians to learn the English education. Lord Macaulay introduced the English education in India in 1834. So after the sati practice was banned, Then another change which came in our country was the English education. Lord Napoleon introduced the English education in the year 1834, and from now onwards the Indian people can also get the English education. The educational method advocated by Macaulay could not benefit you, but the method which the Lord Macaulay were using to provide the English education, to impart this English knowledge to the Indians, it was not appropriate. It did not benefit the Indian youth. The Indians lost the advantage of acquiring the ancient knowledge and skills developed by their ancestors. When the Indians got the English education, they lost the advantage to gain the knowledge of our culture, like our old scriptures which were written by our ancestors. They lost the advantage of gaining, of you know, learning some other skills which our ancestors were having, like to, you know, do agriculture or to do any other certain activities. So we have not got, so that Indians, they have not got benefit of that. They just now were gaining the English education, but they lost their roots. Unke khud ke jo roots the, wahi chale gaye. So what happened next? Let's find out. When Lord Macaulay, he introduced the English education in our country, it was opposed by many intellectuals. That method of imparting the English education was not proper. The method of British education system was opposed by a number of intellectuals, and Mahatma Gandhi himself was having some view on this education. What he told, to give millions the knowledge of English is to enslave them. If we want to give this knowledge to the millions of our Indians, then we are going to enslave them. मतलब ये उनको slave बनाने जैसा है. That by the same English education we have enslaved the nation. And if the Indians have got the English education, that means we have enslaved our whole country. अपने पूरे country को slave बना दिया Britishers का. Why he told so? What was his views? Mahatma Gandhi believed that to impart some knowledge, there should be a proper method. This method which Britishers have brought, it was not proper. It made them see Western civilization as superior and destroyed the pride of they had in their own culture. Now the Indians which were receiving this British education, British English education, they were thinking that Western civilization is superior from us, from our culture, the Indian values. They were pride for us. Earlier they were like our, you know, values which the ancestors have given. It was regarded as pride. Wo hamari bahut garv ki baat hai. But with this education, the pride is lost, our culture is lost. The Indians are distancing themselves from their own people, from their own family, friends, society, their own city, town, country. They are going to, you know, distance themselves and they are going far away from their own roots. अपने roots से ही वो दूर जा रहे हैं. What happened next? Later three universities were established in 1857 in Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. After changing something, after doing certain more reforms, the first three universities were established in the year 1857 in Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata. The Britishers could get the educated workforce now for their administrative work. Now as more and more Indians will get educated, more and more Indians will get to learn this English education, English language, Britishers will get the benefit, as now they will get the more people under them to work in, you know, to work nicely and smoothly in their whole administrative system. It also developed the nationalistic thinking among educated Indians. Now another, you know, side of the coin here is like when the Indians which received this education, they got aware about the things which are there in the Western civilization. So with this they understood that what change our country needs. With this inside them, nationalistic thinking developed, that here as the Indians are not educated, they are thinking right. Other Indians are thinking right that we are the slaves of Britishers. But to change this thing, what they need the guidance, and the guidance, the support, it was provided by the educated Indians only. Inside them a nationalistic feeling emerged. They, you know, wanted to do something great for the country also. Many machines were invented to facilitate industries, transport and communication. Now, as we will progress, the industrial revolution will come. Britishers will have brought the industrial revolution also, and they have introduced many machines. They invented many machines which will help them in the industries, in the transport and communication. Now, let's see what is next in this chapter. Railways were introduced in India in the year 1853. As a result, while all the things were progressing, railways were also brought by the British. The first railway line was started between Mumbai to Thane, and it was done in the year 1853 CE. In order to maintain an effective control on the country and to exchange messages with neighboring territories, modern methods of post and telegraph were introduced in India in 1854. So you have to remember two things, students. 1853 railways were introduced, and in 1854 modern post and telegraph system was introduced in our country by the Britishers. Why the post and telegraph system was introduced? To establish the communication between the neighboring countries and to have an effective control on all the nearby areas. This thing was introduced. With the help of this thing, communication was possible. Printing press and circulation of newspapers grew alongside. With the help of printing press and newspapers, the people, they can know the information around them, what is happening, the events which are happening, what the Britishers are doing, what new reforms they have brought, what new policies they have introduced. Everything they can know in the newspapers and printing press. These reforms which were brought by the Britishers were actually for the convenience of the Britishers. It was for the convenience of the British to live. It was just to help them in running the administration properly. These reforms were actually for the convenience of the British rule in India. All these reforms which were brought by the Britishers, all these things, industrialization, railways, post and telegraph, English education, all these things were started for the convenience of British rule in India. They wanted to get benefit from these things. But it turned out as a blessing in disguise for the growth of nationalism in India. All these reforms, they have turned out to be a blessing for the Indian peoples, because with the help of these, nationalism was started in the people of our country. The nationalist feeling arose, and the people were now thinking that how to make their country free from British rule. So all the efforts of the people of our country were turned towards making the country independent, making the country free, to get the freedom. So that's all about chapter 6, Effects of British Rule in India. I will meet you with the next chapter in the next session. Till then, read the textbook, keep learning. Thank you. Have a nice day.